Summit kiddos, Miss Heather here. I'm so proud of you for watching Kids Church at home. It's so good to know what God's Word, the Bible, says. It will help you live your life. So, think about our classroom experience when you come to church. Think about our picture schedule if you've been. First, we play together. Then we clean up and we do a good job, everyone working together. I'm so proud of you. Next, we do a teaching called Prop Talk, where we show you things that you see often. We tell you how they can remind us of God's Word and what it says. So then when you leave church and you see these things, you'll remember what you learned at church and know what God's Word says. So we're going to play a game to find out what the prop is, what the item is today. Look at my bookshelf and everything around me, and I'm going to give you a clue, and let's see if you can guess it. Ready? Okay. I spy with my little eye something that you go to school with. If you said this backpack, you're right. So you put your backpack on and you go. Oh, wait, before you put your backpack on, what do you got to do? You got to put everything that you're going to need for your adventure or your work or your school. You put everything inside, then you put it on and you go. And this reminds me of God is with us wherever we go, and He has everything we need. He knows everything, and He has a good plan for every adventure, for everywhere you go. So I want you to remember that God is with you wherever you go. And when you see a backpack, I want you to think about that. So friends, after we do our prop talk, we go on to our movie and music, which is a fun way to teach you our Bible stories and sing fun songs. So I sure do hope you enjoy our movie and music today.
On your mark, get set, go on a Bible adventure. So much in the Bible for me to know on my Bible adventure. I wanna know that God is real. I wanna know how I could be His friend. I wanna know who Jesus is. I wanna find out what the Bible's all about. Hey! Do-do-do-do. Set, go on a Bible adventure. So many ways that I will grow on my Bible adventure. I'm gonna learn my memory verse. I'm gonna pray and talk to God. I'm gonna sing new songs to God and keep singing the songs all week long. Oh, do 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 do. On a Bible adventure. Church is a fun place we can go on a Bible adventure.
Oh, hi friends. I was just thinking about my star friend, Shine.
Way! Hiya, Emily! Hiya, friends!
Shine! I'm so glad you're here!
Me too! And I have a question for you. Why did God make me?
Let's go on a Bible adventure to find out! Friends, shake your hands high in the sky if you'll go with me! Woohoo! Friends, pretend to put on your adventure bags.
I have some picture passes that will help you.
Friends, you and I will be picture pass guessers together.
Here's your first clue. It helps you count the days.
Friends, which picture pass is it? Great job, friends. It's the calendar. Catch it in your adventure bags.
Here's your next clue. You can find it outside. It has leaves on it.
Friends, which one is it? I think you're right. It's The tree!
Friends, catch the tree in your adventure bags! Now for your last clue. It's something you carry with you when you have somewhere to go and something to do.
Friends, what do you think it is? I think you've got it! It's the backpack!
Catch it in your adventure bags!
Friends, count with me. 1, 2, 3! Yep, they're all here. Let's zip our adventure bags together. Now it's time to fly!
Whoa!
Whoa! Shine, how will we find the answer to the question, why did God make me?
When we're looking for answers, the Bible is the best place to start.
The Bible is God's book for you. You can trust. It's right and true.
The dreamer. That story's from the book of Genesis in the Bible.
Let's see how it will help us.
Jacob had 12 sons, but he loved his son Joseph the most. He gave Joseph a special brightly colored coat. Joseph's brothers were jealous of him. They hated him. Joseph also had special dreams. In my dream, we were tying up bundles of wheat, he said, and your bundles bowed down to mine. Joseph's brothers hated him even more. Joseph had another dream. The sun, the moon, and 11 stars bowed down before me. His father and brothers grumbled. Are you saying you will rule over us? One day, Joseph's brothers were in the fields watching their sheep. They saw him coming to see them. They planned to kill him and put an end to all his dreams. It would be wrong to kill our brother, said Reuben. Let's throw him in this empty well. So they tore off Joseph's special coat and threw him into the well. Ishmaelite traders came by on their way to Egypt. Let's sell Joseph as a slave to the Ishmaelites, suggested Judah. So the brothers sold Joseph for 20 pieces of silver. The brothers dipped Joseph's coat in goat's blood and showed it to Jacob. My son is dead, he wept. Meanwhile, Joseph was taken to Egypt, but God was with Joseph. In Egypt, the Ishmaelites sold Joseph to Potiphar, one of Pharaoh's captains. God blessed Joseph and made him successful. Potiphar put Joseph in charge of his whole household.
Wow, Joseph had some strange dreams, and some bad things happened to him too.
But that wasn't the end of Joseph's story. His dreams came true. God had good plans for Joseph.
He did?
Yeah, God made Joseph a great leader. God's plans for us are always good.
Hey, that's great. But I still don't know the answer to the question. Why did God make me?
Maybe Guy, the Bible guy, can help.
That's a great idea. I'm gonna go ask him. See ya, Shine.
See ya, Emily.
Come on.
Come in.
Hi, Guy.
Hi, Emily. Hi, friends.
I was hoping you could help me answer a question. Why did God make me?
God has good plans for me.
Hey, that's what Shine said.
Well, Shine is one very bright star.
But I don't know what God's plan even means.
God's plans are the good things he wants you to do. And his plans for everyone who loves and follows Jesus are always good.
I do that, Guy. I really try to love and follow Jesus every day.
That's great! You can be sure that God has good plans for all your days.
All your days? I have a picture pass about that. Friends, which picture pass helps you count the days? Way to go, friends! It's the calendar. The calendar shows us every day that's coming.
That's right. And God has a plan for every day. We don't know what will happen, but God knows, and His plans for us are so good.
Hey, do you know a Bible verse about that?
Sure do. Friends, wiggle your ears if you're ready to learn a verse with me.
I'm wiggling my ears. Are you wiggling yours?
Okay. Listen to what God says in the Bible. Jeremiah 29:11. I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord. They are plans for good. So good, so good.
Friends, say the verse with me.
Jeremiah 29:11.
Jeremiah 29:11.
I know the plans.
I know the plans.
I have for you.
I have for you.
Says the Lord.
Says the Lord.
They are plans for good. So good, so good.
They are plans for good. So good, so good.
Friends, that's it. Now say the whole verse with us.
Jeremiah 29:11. I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord. They are plans for good. So good, so good.
Friends, great job.
Thanks for the verse. Bye, guys.
Bye, Emily. Bye, friends.
Come on.
He's so good.
La, 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 la. Do, 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 do. Oh, hi, Xenia. Hey, you have your backpack. That can only mean one thing.
Oh, yeah? What's that?
You have somewhere to go and something to do.
You're right about that.
Well, you don't seem very happy about it.
I'm not. I can't stay with my mommy and daddy right now. So I have to go stay with my Aunt Petunia.
That doesn't sound so bad.
But I've never stayed with my Aunt Petunia. What if she's mean to me? And who will I play with? Blinky, I'm scared.
You don't have to be afraid, Xenia. God has super-de-duper good plans for us.
But this doesn't seem good at all.
God's plans are always good, even when things don't seem very good.
I don't know about that.
Xenia, remember when you were afraid of the dark and you trusted God?
I do remember. After that, I never needed a nightlight again.
That's because you knew God was with you then, and He's with you now.
And He has good plans for me. Blinky, will you pray for me so I never forget that ever again?
You bet I will. Dear God, please help Xenia and all of us remember that Your plans for us are good, no matter what. In Jesus' name, amen.
Okay. Well, I'm off to do the good things God has planned for me.
I'll miss you, Xenia, but I'll see you when you get back. And I know God is with you.
Thanks, Blinky. Friends forever?
Friends forever. High five.
Yeah.
Yeah. See you soon.
Okay. Bye.
Friends, I'm so glad Guy figured out the answer to the question. Why did God make me. Friends, say the answer with me. God has good plans for me. The calendar shows us that God has good plans for us every day. I want to do the good things God has planned for me because His plans are good. It's like our Bible verse says, Jeremiah 29:11. I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord. They are plans for good. So good, so good. Do you hear that? You know what that means. Mr. Music must have a song for us. Come on, let's go.
Ooh, hi, Emily. Hi, friends.
Hi, Mr. Music. Do you know the answer to the question, why did God make me?
God has good plans for me.
Yeah, that's right.
God has a plan for everything He made. That includes all of us.
God made you and me and flowers and trees. Wait, I have a picture pass about that. Friends, which picture pass can you find outside? It has leaves on it. That's right, friends. It's the tree. Mr. Music, what plans does God have for a tree?
What good things did God make trees to do?
Well, trees give us shade from the sun. And they make nuts and fruit for the animals to eat.
That's right. And for us too. I love eating the fruit that grows on trees, like apples and oranges.
Oh, and bananas. And peaches! Oh, I'm so glad that God has plans for trees!
And God has a plan for you, too. And His plans are always good.
Do you know a song about that?
I do. Friends, clap your hands together if you'd like to sing a song with me.
I'm clapping my hands. Are you clapping yours?
Okay. Let's start with the part that we sing together.
Okay.
It goes like this. When God leads me somewhere new, He has good things for me to do. Sing it with me.
When God leads me somewhere new, He has good things for me to do.
Let's sing the whole song together.
Okay, friends, sing with me.
Here we go. God has a plan.
God has a plan.
A plan for me.
A plan for me.
A plan for you.
A plan for you.
We know it's true.
His plans are good.
His plans are good.
All the time.
All the time.
No matter what.
No matter what.
So we can trust in Him. Singing la 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 la. La la la. Somewhere new, He has good things for me to do.
Yeah!
When God leads me somewhere new, He has good things for me to do.
God has a plan.
God has a plan.
A plan for me.
A plan for me.
A plan for you.
A plan for you.
We know it's true.
His plans are good.
His plans are good.
All the time.
All the time.
No matter what.
No matter what.
So we can trust in Him. Singing la 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 la. La 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 la. When God leads me somewhere new, He has good things for me to do.
Again!
When God leads me somewhere new, He has good things for me to do.
Yeah!
He has good things for me to do. He has good things for me to do.
You guys sound great! Now, stand up on your feet to worship God with music, singing, and dancing.
Father God, I am yours. Every day I will say, Father God, I am yours. I am a child of God. Shimmy up when I am sad. You make me smile when I am mad. Every day you make me glad. I am a child of God. Father God, I am yours. Every day I will say, Father God, I am yours. I am a child of God. Cheer me up when I am sad. Make me smile when I am mad. Every day you make me glad. I am a child of God. You cheer me up when I am sad. You make me smile when I am mad. Every day you make me glad. I am a child of God. I am a child of God. I am a child of God.
So mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. He made the trees, he made the seas, he made the elephants too. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. Strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. The mountains are his, the valleys are his, the stars are his handiwork too. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do.
Shine! Friends, do you hear that star? Shine, there you are! We've had so much fun on our Bible adventure!
Did you find the answer to the question, why did God make me?
Yup, yup, yuppers! Friends, say it with me. God has good plans for me!
That's right! And what Bible verse did God teach you?
Friends, let's say it for Shine. Jeremiah 29:11. I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord. They are plans for good. So good, so good.
God's plans are good. What did you find out about the picture passes?
The calendar lets me know that God has good things for me to do every day.
Every day is part of God's good plan.
And the tree reminds me that God has a plan for everything he made. Even the trees. Even me.
And God's plans are always good.
Oh, but I still don't know about the backpack.
The backpack is something you carry with you when you have somewhere to go and something to do.
Shine! That's it! God has good plans for me. When He leads me somewhere new, He has good things for me to do.
Wee! Now let's pray for our friends so they will know God has good plans for them too.
Okay. Friends, bow your heads and close your eyes. We're going to talk to God together. Dear God, thank you for planning good things for us to do. Help us to love and follow you. In Jesus' name, amen. Pandas and popsicles, it's time to go. We'll see you next time.
For another Bible adventure.
Bye-bye, friends.
Okay, wasn't that a great movie and music? I sure do think it's so silly when Emily says things like pandas and popsicles. It makes me laugh. And then I just love the story of Joseph, where, you know, his life wasn't always easy, but he still continued to do good things, trust in God, and God blessed him for that. So I hope that you can learn from Joseph's good example. Now, after our movie and music, we do our picture passes. So I have Emily's picture passes with me now. I want you to try to guess which one's going to be first. The backpack. When God takes you somewhere new, what does He plan for you to do? If you said good things, you're right. I like that. Good job. Next, the calendar. Who is with us on good days, bad days, and really every day? If you said God, you're right. Good job. Last, the tree. What are some good plans that God has for trees? Because He has a good plan for everything He made, right? If you said things like shade, they give us fruit and nuts. If you said things like it's a home for some animals. If you even said, because I think they're pretty, that's good because God made them for us to enjoy, right? All those are good answers. So, friends, after we do our picture passes, we break up into small groups. And we, as teachers, have a small, about 15 minutes of time that we can connect with you kids and retell the story, have snack together, do our adventure books, pray. So let's pray right now together. Lord, thank you for each family watching. I ask that you would show them your good plan for their life. Lord, that they would know that you're with them wherever they go and whatever they do. Lord, I ask that you would bless each family. In Jesus' name, amen. Well, I sure do feel better, and I hope you do too. Have an awesome week, Summit Kids. Bye.